Wasi outpost, Akonde Sadikwe apologies for the agony of Nigerians in diaspora. Member House of Representatives representing Oluyole Federal Constituency, Honorable Tolulope Akonde Sadikwe, on Tuesday via a press release has apologized for the agony of Nigerians in diaspora, most especially people of Tiv descent, as a result of the petitions issued on the floor of the House on Thursday, 11th March 2021. The Chairman House Committee on Diaspora emphasized that the petition has been received by her, compiled, and that the leadership of the House and the Committee on Diaspora has commenced investigations. Your numerous petitions and messages have been well received by me, compiled, and is being investigated by the leadership of the House and the Diaspora Committee. The issue is of utmost importance to the House of Representatives, and it will be resolved in a matter of days, she said. Akonde Sadikwe stressed that the House would continue to value and prioritize the needs and requests of Nigerians, both at home and in the diaspora. Thank you for listening to this news. What you have just done is good, okay? But the question is, these people you are pleading on behalf, are they ready to change? Are they ready? Are they ready to change? I tell you, of a truth, we still have good people in Nigeria anyway. But the bad ones are in majority than the good ones. There is a reason why Honorable Akonde is apologizing, because he has gone, he has seen, he has witnessed, he was not told. So he felt perplexed and said, wow, is this Nigerians doing this in diaspora? So that is why sometimes when you see Nigerians deported, repatriated, you'll be surprised what's happening. Now, let me tell you, nobody gets surprised anymore if any Nigerian is repatriated. Because definitely, if any Nigerian is repatriated, definitely he must have committed one or two offense. And you know, America now, there is no free entry or free exit in America. Like, unlike Nigeria that has free entry and free exit, they accommodate every dick and harry into their country, not minding who the person is. If the person is a Boko person, if the person is a killer, if this person is a bandit, they accommodate him. Look at our country, Nigeria, now. Our country is filled with China investment. Yeah, China investment. As we speak now, the China control the economy of Nigeria. Now, aside from Dangote, the Chinese has the highest shares in the Nigerian economy. The Chinese determine the strength of the Nigerian economy. They determine the GDP, the growth of the GDP in the Nigerian economy. Do you understand now that there will be a positive slope of the demand curve of the Nigerian GDP depends on the Chinese investment now in Nigeria, and Nigerian government is the one that caused all of that. They gave room for Chinese to come in, take advantage of our lands, build giant industries, employ our citizens, the Nigerian citizens, as slaves, use them to make more money, get expand, control our economy. Oh shit. You need to see, come to Nigeria and see yourself now. Is it not last on 2019 that Nigerians are lamenting that, see what Chinese are doing to Nigerians that are working for them? Just because Nigerians are working for the Chinese, they are molesting Nigerians. They treat them like slaves, like animals. They beat them, they molest them, they frustrate them just because they are working for them. During the COVID-19, some Nigerians were locked inside the factory for 14 days. For 14 days, for them not to see outside, just working all through 14 days. They did not allow them to go out. They locked them up with force. With force. Anyone that refused to work, they beat him up. It's someone that made it to be exposed. You see, these are the things that we experience in Nigeria. These are the things that we go through, which is not okay. Eh? We even the country that we are traveling to, we still go there to turn to slave. In America, they don't allow that shit in America. They don't allow it. They don't allow that shit in America at all. They don't allow it. In America, there is nothing like free entry, free exit. There is nothing like that in America. They don't allow it. They do their se they select who comes to their country, and that is why you need to undergo a rigorous interview before you'll be given a visa to travel abroad. Look at, but in Nigeria, Aya, you are welcome, no matter who you are, be you a criminal, a bandit, a molester, a prostitute, you are welcome. Come in, come in, come in, come in. Can you imagine? My viewers, it's pathetic. It's pathetic. We just have to tell ourselves the truth. It's not helping matters. So please, deem it fit to leave your comment below the comment section. Click on the subscription buttons as well as the bell buttons to get updated each time we upload any new videos. Thank you.